Hello and welcome to the Wabi Sabi Land. After many years of traveling around and searching, we finally found a place that we love next to our friends who also have kids, and we now are able to finally start to live our dream, to live a sustainable life where we take care of Mother Earth, live with nature, and to connect to ourselves. In April we started to work on the little land and to create a little garden. We have kind of two lands, a bigger one and a smaller one, and we could start to work on the little one already in April. And then we had some friends visiting who were helping in the garden. And our little one, he just loved the wheelbarrow all spring long. He was sitting there having a lot of fun. Yeah, it's just beautiful. He can run around, play, and explore. Just being outside all day long. So we put a lot of love and effort into our garden because we wanted to be able to eat our own veggies this summer, and we are. So a couple of months later, here we are having loads of cucumbers, zucchinis, tomatoes, and this is our little camp, the tent and the outdoor kitchen with a little shading roof. Our little one running around like crazy, being happy. Yeah. We're so blessed because he's playing on his own a lot, so we can work at the same time. There, Mark is creating or planning the tiny house. We also have some fruit trees on the big land, and I was drying loads of figs and peaches, apples and pears. Yeah, it's such a blessing. And on the little land, the one main challenge was to enter it with the cars. I drove in some scratches into the little car. And now we decided to open the entrance. But for that, the olive tree had to be moved. And we weren't 100% sure if it would work, but we were lucky and it survived. And yeah, on this land that has very little trees, we're just so grateful for every tree that we can have there. It has been a little adventure to replant a tree. Yeah, once you start such a project, the to-do list just gets longer and longer, and it never ends. So it really teaches us to stay focused and calm at the same time and not to get overwhelmed. There, Mark is fixing the fence. And we are lucky to have a nice water hole on the little land that we have been jumping into all summer. And now September is here, so it's a great time to make a deeper pond, make it a little bit bigger so we have a water retention place where we can store the water that is falling in winter, and we will be able to water our garden, and at the same time we have a little lake to swim in summer, which is really a big, big luxury. And yeah, some days later, the tiny house delivery arrived with a lot of insulation and nearly all the wood. We found an Austrian guy who had good wood. It's not always easy to find good wood in Portugal. And anyway, we would have loved to build more with the things that are on the land. But now winter is coming and time is short and building with wood is just very fast, and we decided to go for the tiny house now. Mark has been designing everything, and I'm giving a helping hand, being a little bit clumsy once in a while. Yeah, I fell in love with a carpenter. I will never regret it. I'm so grateful for that every single day. Yeah, building with wood is also so rewarding because you see the results so quickly. And it's just a beautiful material. We celebrate every little step when we're dancing around and just living life. It really feels like we are alive here. Yeah, so welcome to join us on our journey. We will upload videos about everything, how we're building everything up, what challenges we are facing, how it's going with our neighbors. And yeah, we are happy to see you in the next video.